Marian here. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to talk all about whether or not you need to buy an infant carrier seat, a bucket seat, or if you can just have a convertible car seat. So I wanted to share with you guys all the pros and cons and help you figure out this decision. If you're new to my channel, welcome. My name is Marian and I make videos about being a mom and being a Jewish mom, and I'd love to have you as one of my subscribers, especially if you're interested in newborn and baby content, because I've got a little baby on the way. I also have a 4-year-old and a 2-year-old, so I know all about baby stuff and I'm kind of obsessed with it. If you watch my channel, you'll see I do tons of reviews of things like this. Also, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you like it, and feel free to follow me on Instagram if you want to follow along with my everyday life as a Jewish mom. Okay, so let's jump in. Bucket seat, I've also heard them called pumpkin seats, infant seats, newborn seats. Do you need one of these kind of car seats? So at first, I did not understand. When I was a first-time mom, so if you have this question, believe me, you are not alone. I did not understand why you would buy a whole car seat that would only last a year. And many of them range in price range from like $100 to $400. So it is an expense. So this is the number one reason why you should get an infant car seat if you're considering it. It is able to come out of the car. It clicks in and out of the car and into a stroller or a base. So what's great about that is when you have a little baby who's tucked into their car seat comfortably and you need to run an errand, like go to the grocery store, pick up your older kid from school or whatever you're doing, you don't have to take them out of the car seat. You just, this is the Upa Baby Mesa car seat. So for example, in this one, you just press this button, it releases the latches on both sides, you lift it up out of the car and click it right into the stroller. And then I would take my baby out and about in their car seat all the time. Like, we never use the seat of the stroller until he was past the age of using this car seat. By the way, this car seat maxes out at age 1. It also has a weight limit and a height limit, and you want to make sure that your baby is not too big for this seat, so they might outgrow it before age 1. This is the one like milestone in car seats where you don't want to wait too long. Once they're once they've maxed it out, you need to move on to the convertible seat. So just that caveat, if you have like a huge baby, they might not get the full year in the car seat, in this car seat. Okay, so what's great about not having to take them out of the car seat if you are a first-time mom and don't know what it's like going around with a baby, is babies are not wired for change. Once they're comfy somewhere, they don't like to be taken in and out, placed somewhere else. So it's very hard when you're newborn or your baby is cozy and comfy or maybe even asleep to then have to take them out, especially in the winter. And I do just wanna mention a few things about car seats. You should never put your baby in a car seat with a coat on. Even an older kid should not, apparently an adult also, should not be wearing a coat in a car seat, because if there is an accident, there's so much pressure and force that you aren't able to tighten the straps as tight as you would, as tight as they'll go in an accident, versus if they're not wearing a jacket, you'll be able to get it to the right tightness. So this is a winter cover that actually goes on top of the car seat, so it's not, doesn't affect the straps or the buckle at all, but still keeps them warm. And when you take them out of the car, okay, sorry, just had to pop a new memory card in my camera. I honestly don't remember what I was saying. I think I was talking about winter stuff and how it's really nice to have that winter cover. Other nice cover type of thing to have is one of these. I only use this outside of the car. This is by Aiden and Anai. It's got these straps that you can hook on to the handlebars. So if your baby is sleeping or you just don't want strangers like coming up and getting too close, you can put this on and then it will cover the car seat and kind of protect your baby also from the sun a little bit, although this does have some sun protection. But yeah, just a few little accessories that are really nice if you are taking this in and out. So the infant car seat comes with a base. it looks like this. So this is what you, this is the Appa Baby Mesa again. This is what you install into your car, either with the latch system, which are these that buckle into this like little slot in your seat of the car, or with the seat belt you can install it. And then you don't have to worry about installing the car seat every time. You again, literally just pop it in and out. If you have a convertible car seat, you can't take the car seat in and out. You have to take the child in and out. So I always dread when my kid gets to one, I can't use this anymore because it's so convenient. I'm like, oh no, I have to take them in and out. But at that point, they're usually so heavy that it's so hard to lift the car seat in and out that they're fine. They're ready for the convertible. So just something to keep in mind. Also, weight is something to consider when you are researching these infant type of car seats, because the heavier they are, the harder it is to walk around with them and lift them in and out of the car. Also, if you're not getting like an Appa Baby, which is a whole system, the stroller fits with the car seat, etc., you want to make sure to get a stroller base, or these just like regular push bases. They're not technically strollers, but there's some that are like $50 that just attach to the infant seat. So you want to make sure if you are getting an infant seat that you have a stroller or a base to walk around with to make it worth it to take the car seat in and out. Because if you don't have that stroller to attach it to, I don't know how much use you're gonna get out of taking this in and out of the car, because it's too heavy to just, you know, walk around with it, obviously. Another thing just to remember for safety is that you should never have your child be sleeping in the car seat, like unattended kind of thing. So if they fall asleep in the car, yes, you can bring the car seat in the house, but you need to be very careful and watch them and to make sure they're not sleeping for too long amount of time. Car seats have like recommended number of hours, but it should be short, and you should be monitoring them if you do bring the car seat in, for example. You also want to make sure if you're walking around with the car seat in the stroller that the straps are still on, because babies can very easily slide. They might go chin to chest, and a lot of other things can happen. So the straps are not just there to protect them in an accident, but to make sure they're correctly placed in a correct recline in the seat. So that's really important, is if you do have a product like this, to be careful when you're using it and to know how it's used, because things like this sometimes are so convenient that it's easy to make mistakes and not realize that you're being unsafe. So I just give that caveat. So that is my little brief overview of why you should or should not get an infant car seat. I definitely recommend it if it's in your budget to get one, because I think it is a huge help with little babies, especially to be able to pop them in and out. But it is an extra expense, and it is something that has a finite amount of time it can be used. Car seats also expire. So we bought this for my oldest son, who's now 4 and a half. By the time our next baby is born, this car seat will only have 1 year left on it. I think it has a 6 or 7 year lifespan, and most of the time, by the time you get the car seat, it's already 1 year into its lifespan, and you cannot go over. Once they're expired, you cannot use them anymore. So if you are having kids far apart and you're thinking you'll just save it for the next one, you need to be. So I hope you guys found this review and information helpful. If you did, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions I can answer for you, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!